Long after the prospecting era, oil and gas wells from the 19th and 20th centuries litter the landscape and are leaking harmful chemicals and gases into the environment. In places like Shenango River Lake in western Pennsylvania, the BLM is working alongside its federal partners to find these orphaned wells with an end goal of stopping those leaks and restoring the land. The work begins in the office with time-intensive research to find wells that often have little or no paper trail.
Oh, here it is.
I found this on a screen by downloading the state of Pennsylvania's GIS data that show their conventional wells, meaning wells that go straight down vertically instead of horizontally. So that database tells me when the wells were drilled, when they were plugged. This one didn't have a plug date, and it was listed by the state of Pennsylvania as abandoned or orphaned. And so we suspected it was out here, and now we've found it. Now we know it's here. Now we know where it is, and we can look around at the other resources and see how we can get heavy equipment in here to plug this. The cable's off to our right. I'm just gonna follow it north. So I'll be a little bit off to your right if you keep going straight north.
The most time-consuming and difficult part of the process is heading deep into the forest to physically find an orphaned well. Once it's located, the impacts of the rusting relics are assessed.
Some of the data in here are already filled in from the data that we got from the state of Pennsylvania. Like this one is on the DEP abandoned list, meaning they've determined that this well is abandoned, and we'll gather some more data on here, like which equipment is here. So we had a point on a map. Now we're here. Now we see that the equipment is a wellhead, and that's going to help determine how big of a job it's going to be to pull that out of there.
Even if the old map data is precise, many of the wells can still be difficult to locate.
Well, I haven't seen the wellhead. It's in here somewhere. You know, this kind of vegetation, this tall vegetation, illustrates how hard it is to find these wells when we don't have pump jacks and tanks. And we think there are several more wells in here. And experiences like this, where we crawl around and fight the roses and the ticks to try to find these wells, illustrates why we are turning more and more to technologies like UAS, uncrewed aerial systems, also known as drones, carrying a magnetometer. And that's a great way to find a well if there's still steel in it. So during World War II, a lot of wells were stripped where the casing was pulled out to build ships and other things for the war. And here, if there's still a casing, a drone with a magnetometer could find it. Also, if these wells are leaking methane, a drone carrying a methane sensing device, which is basically an infrared camera, can also find those methane plumes and pinpoint those wells that we otherwise wouldn't be able to find.
Whether it's through research, technology, or old-fashioned legwork, the BLM is doing its part to find and plug orphaned wells so they no longer pollute the land, water, and air.